Jr., a little bit different from his father, is definitely have to lead this team in today's game.
Mountaineers controlling the opening tip, got off to a slow start against UConn last Saturday, came back and beat Pittsburgh on Monday night, and Joe Alexander, he is still feeling it.
Joe Alexander has been hot the last couple of games. When you see him getting in the post, he will face up majority of the game, and that's his go-to move.
Eugene Lawrence with the basketball, wrapping up his St. John's career. The senior over to the freshman, DJ Kennedy. Well, the St. John's team, that Dickey filled with rookies.
This St. John's team is definitely young, but it's a good sign for next year. You know, they have Mason Jr. as a leader. They have some promising young players. Very important for coming into next year.
Last bucket by Anthony Mason Jr. leads the team with 14. He's had a couple of good games back-to-back, 16 and 24. There's a little traveling music on Deshaun Butler. Let's check the starting lineups of the game. First of all, West Virginia. You see Nichols, he is the senior. Alex Ruoff has 85 threes, third in the Big East. Deshaun Butler, 67 offensive rebounds. Alexander, Jamie Smoligan, the 7-footer, who had a great defensive game, according to Bob Huggins, against DeJuan Blair of Pittsburgh on Monday. Lawrence outside, bring it up, that's a three for the senior.
I'm expecting Lawrence to have a great game today. This is his last game as a senior. The guys are wearing headbands for him. I'm looking for him to really make a statement before he finishes out his career.
And it's been a pretty good career too, Dickie. I mean, he's third all-time in threes. That's his 25th this season. Outside shot, that's a three ball by the lefty, Nichols.
Nichols can do that. He can knock down threes. He's a real steady point guard. He's going to give you solid play, and that's what you need in a point guard, especially going into the tournament.
Kennedy on the drive, kisses it off the window. DJ Kennedy, last six games, he's been in double figures. That's his first bucket.
One of the big keys for West Virginia is going to be how they guard the ball one-on-one. That's very important.
But these Mountaineers really have embraced that man-to-man. After playing all that zone under John Beilein, they love getting physical under Bob Huggins.
Hey, Bob Huggins came in and he changed the game. You guys are gonna have to learn how to play some one-on-one defense.
This is Alexander off the dribble. Finally missed a shot. Larry Harrison, the assistant coach, said, I don't think he missed a shot in practice this week after his back-to-back 32-point games. He has been in a groove.
Well, Alexander is a versatile forward. He's a guy who's going to face up a lot. He can take you off the dribble, and he's also athletic. So he will dunk on somebody if they get in the way.
We talk about the illustrious career of Eugene Lawrence with the basketball. I had mentioned he's third. I was just corrected. He's actually fourth, but a good chance of becoming third here this afternoon. Baseline jumper partially deflected by Alexander. Out of bounds, it stays on this end. Let's check the starting lineup now for the Red Storm of St. John's. Lawrence is the senior. Anthony Mason Jr., the leading scorer. DJ Kennedy's a rookie, as is Justin Burrell. And Delly Coker, the 6'11", 270-pounder. So three rookies in the starting lineup.
They have a lot of rookies in the starting lineup. Again, that's great promise for the future. And Lawrence, as a point guard, he's got a lot of shoes to fill with the great point guards that have played here at St. John's.
Well, the foul goes against the rookie Justin Burrell, but Burrell said there's no way you're going to score on this in transition. So Deshaun Butler will be going to the line, a 66% shooter. 6'7", 225 sophomore, good size, great freshman year. Plus, he's put on 25 pounds since last year.
Well, that shows me good signs of a guy coming back in his second year. He didn't take off in the summertime. He had a great freshman year. Comes back, gains 25 pounds of muscle, and now, hey, I'm going to come out and show what I can do and make sure you understand that it's not a fluke.
He loves this athletic, physical concept of Bob Huggins. As a matter of fact, Butler, they said, probably one of the best freshman years in school history. There's a reach by Smoligan.
Well, you know, the difficult thing in college basketball is when you've been at a program, and, for example, Smoligan's been there, he's a senior, and then you get a new coach. That's a big change right there.
Well, that's a great point. I mean, his whole career is knocking threes down. And Bob Huggins said he's really, really improved this year, though. As you see, the field goals, 2 for 3 for the Mountaineers. So he's really, really tried to play with his back to the basket, and he played some great defense against Duane Blair on Monday. Larry Smolik in there with the deflection and the steal. Nichols all alone, ring it up. That's a three for Darius Nichols. He's got six.
Like I said before, he can do that. He's a solid point guard. That was real easy. They pushed it down on the break. He came into the sweet spot. You call that the sweet spot. He caught it, squared up, and knocked it down.
Sometimes you're so wide open, it's hard to knock those down. Like that time, he's contested, but blows a hole in my theory because he missed the shot. Well, Bob Huggins, a member of the 600 club, he joined that club on December 22nd, now 611 victories, just his first year on the bench at West Virginia, his alma mater. It's interesting, born in Morgantown, graduated from there, a two-time academic All-American. What do you really like about Bob Huggins' team?
I really like Bob Huggins' style because his assistant coaches recruit well. He gets great players, athletic, strong, and then he teaches that strong one-on-one defense. And when you can do that, you build winning teams. And as you can see in his career, he's always had winning teams.
Really loves these kids, too, he said. But probably to get his team, the kind of team the Cincinnati Bearcats had, probably takes about three recruiting classes.
Whenever you come into a new program as a head coach, it takes you at least 3 years to really get your recruiting class in, get your philosophy going with that team.
Alex Ruoff steps outside. That's his 86th three-pointer of the season.
Now, Ruoff can do that. I hope St. John's paid attention to the scout report because he can knock down threes.
Both teams shooting the ball well, 4 for 6. The 15:08 to go here in the first half. And it's interesting talking with Bob Huggins about Ruoff. He said he can knock it down. He probably could be shooting better than he is right now. Lawrence missed the stick back, and Alexander gets the rebound.
Well, whenever you're coaching a guy who can shoot, you always want him to shoot a little bit better. If he misses one shot out of 10, you know, you want him to make 10 out of 10.
Sounds like you've been around a lot of coaches in your career. Nice feed inside. And before the shot, the foul was committed as they pulled his jersey. DJ Kennedy picks up his first. Alex Ruoff. This is number 86 on the year. His Mountaineers on top by 2. Well, back inside Madison Square Garden, the Mountaineers by 2. 11-9 over St. John's. And Dickie, let's take a look down at the Principal Financial Group edge to the game.
Well, West Virginia, like I talked about before, they have to really focus on improving their one-on-one defense. And then like we talked in the opening, every win counts right now because you're really trying to make that statement. For St. John's, you want to come out and set the tone. As a competitive player in the Big East, you want to be playing for something every time you step on the court. So let's play for pride. Let's have some pride on this court, Mike.
I love to hear you say that because how many times, let's switch gears and talk about football. How many times a team doesn't make the bowl game that they want to play in and they go to a lesser bowl per se and all of a sudden they just get run over?
You can't do that. And I know Coach Roberts is not going to let them fall into that slump because he's building for next year with this young team.
Harris Horn gives up the rock to Malik Booth and he loses him. Deshaun Butler comes up with the basketball for West Virginia. You talk about that defense. They played so much zone under John Beilein, and then they embraced the man-to-man. First five conference games for West Virginia, they faced the league's top seven scorers, and only two actually hit their average. Probably needs more size, more bangers as Alexander knocks down his second shot.
If you let Alexander post up that easy in the paint, he's going to use his athletic ability to shoot right over you and knock those jump shots down. You have to be a little bit more physical and keep him out the paint.
Three ball doesn't go from the pocket. Alexander looking for Deshaun Butler, a little bit too strong.
That's okay. I like Alexander coming down court. He was letting Butler know, hey, I'm right here on the side. That's a sign of a guy who's filling the game, who's filling hot, who's playing well, and who's a leader.
That's what Bob Huggins was saying earlier this year. He said, we have to share the ball. And if we don't share the ball, if we do, we can beat anybody. If we don't, we just don't have enough scorers inside that can score from inside. There's the whistle, some traveling music, and it's coming back the other way. Fourth turnover now for St. John's. They come in averaging 15 a game.
With a young team, you always see a lot of turnovers as they grow and get to know each other. Anthony Mason Jr. tried to make a pass to Varell. Miscommunication on the screen and roll.
Norm Roberts getting a vote of confidence last week. The school stepping up and saying that Norm definitely will be back for a fifth year. Of course, Roberts making the Big East tournament last year, finishing 16-15. In all fairness, I mean, they have a lot this year, five wins, but they. Anthony Mason Jr., the injury he had definitely hurt this team as far as picking up more W's.
Well, Norm Roberts has done a great job with a young team. He's done a great job since he's been here with the academic success rate of the players. So it would make sense to keep him here, especially with the young talent they have moving forward.
Alexander, a little step back, knocked down several of those against UConn. Last Saturday in Hartford, inside. Boy, St. John's playing strong as Justin Burrell takes it in, and he's called for the charge. That's his second, and I don't think he agreed with that call, Dickey.
Well, hey, that's Smith giving up his body. He gives up his body. Smith's in position. You see on the defense, Alexander gambles, but Smith gives his body up. That's championship basketball right there. That's making a statement for NCAA, giving up your body.
West Virginia in the lead, 13-9. Their coaching staff saying that slow starts on the road have hurt this team. They're up right now, but you talk about St. John's playing for pride. St. John's playing very hard so far. Boy, Alexander uses that window nice, doesn't he?
That's a nice shot off the glass. Like I said before, Alexander is going to be mostly face-up player. Every time he gets his, he's going to use his great footwork, inside reverse pivot, and shoot facing up.
Mountaineers on a 7-0 run as they open up the 15-9 lead. They come in averaging about 76 points a game. And St. John's giving up about 66, but they don't score a lot, 62 on the year. Evans with a rebound.
Well, West Virginia is going to definitely take their time every time down on offense. They're going to set good screens. That's one thing about West Virginia. They're going to set solid screens and be patient until they get an open shot.
Top of the broadcast, you said on the West Virginia resume, you like it's the Big East. It's the Big East Conference, the toughest conference around. And I think it was Tom Crean said it earlier this year, if you come into a game thinking you're 10 or 12 points better than the other team, you're going to find yourself 10 or 12 points down in the first half.
Mike, that's exactly right. This is the Big East, the top conference in the NCAA right now. And West Virginia came out at the beginning of the season ranked in the nation. So any game, anytime, anybody can win.
Well, talk about sharing the rock. A beautiful pass. 9-0 run as Ruoff now hits a second bucket. He has five. And the Mountaineers, a lot of high fives. They want to take care of business here and wrap up their 22nd win of the season.
I like West Virginia's energy. They seem to be very focused.
Let's check some Big East news and notes. The Cards, of course, over the nation's capital, battling the Hoyas for the regular season championship and the number one seed. How about your alma mater, huh? They need a win over Villanova for a trip to the Garden. What a big win for them against UConn.
Well, they're coming back the last couple of games. They've got some big wins that's going to help them if they can get into the Big East tournament with this win today, which I will be at that game also. I'm doing a Superman flight from here to Providence to watch that game because they're honoring some great players at halftime. Marvin Barnes, Ernie D, Jimmy Walker.
Well, at Cincinnati, a UConn game scheduled for today. They'll play it tomorrow. They had 12 inches of snow in Cincinnati. And the Bearcats couldn't even get out.
Yeah, the weather in the Midwest in that Ohio area is pretty tough today.
All right, let's go back and relive that. How are you getting to Providence? By car, by train, by plane?
I think I'm going to take Dwight Howard's cape he used in the dunk contest and do a Superman flight to Providence.
Okay, just stay away from Steve Martin and I was going to say John Candy, but I guess he's since passed, so there's no chance you're going to bump into him. With you see the shooting now, St. John's. On the year, the Red Storm coming in, shooting about 41%. Now trying to cut into that 9-0 run of West Virginia.
Mike, we talked about at the beginning having some pride in playing. Every game counts. Right now, my pride is getting better, getting ready for next year, and playing as a team because we have great promise as a St. John. In this history here, they will get back in track.
Joe Alexander, He's got six in the ball game, and right now his team leads 17-9. Back at the Garden after this. Back in New York, 17-9 West Virginia. Dickie, take us inside the play.
Well, as you can see right here, West Virginia, they do a great job moving without the ball. All the young kids out there watching basketball, you don't have to have the ball in your hands all the time. You have to get good spacing, come off screens, use your screen and get your man stuck. When the ball comes to you, you have a wide open shot, as you can see Alexander, moving without the ball.
That's a great teaching line, because a lot of kids don't get that, even young kids. Some kids, it's like an innate ability. They just know they have to move without the ball, and some guys just kind of stand around.
When you watch basketball now in high school and the younger kids, everybody thinks they need to have the ball in their hand the whole game. You can actually score without having the ball, bringing it down, keeping it in your hands. All you have to do is make good cuts. If you set a screen for somebody, usually you'll be open to get the shot.
And sooner or later, that defender will get tired of chasing you around, and you will find some open shots.
Definitely the defender will get tired of following you around. But with Alexander's case, he's the go-to guy on his team. So he's going to be more likely to get open. They're going to get him open so they can keep him hot like he's been the last couple of games.
There's the numbers on DJ Kennedy, another freshman, 6'6", rookie out of Pittsburgh. Really had a good start to his season when Anthony Mason Jr. was actually out on the bench with an injury. Knocked down a couple of double-doubles, so knocks down the free throw there. 72% shooter. He's got three. Now the Mountaineers facing some pressure. Earlier we talked about sharing the rock. West Virginia, 8 field goals, 8 assists so far here this afternoon.
That's a key stat, especially when you're trying to prepare yourself for the Big East tournament and prepare yourself for the NCAA tournament. Sharing the ball is a big stat.
John Evans with the flush.
Whoa! Now that's setting the tone right there. That's playing for something.
Dickie Evans has really been coming on. 6'8", 242 pounder. He was all city in football and basketball in Philadelphia. Probably a better football player coming in, but he's really been improving. Rebound offensively for West Virginia. Foul goes against St. John's. I believe it's a Paris Horn, the 6'3 freshman from Delaware. All right, Dickie, defense leading the offense here with the steal.
Yes, Evans jumped in the passing lane. You see he got the ball, handling it as a big player, bringing it down the court with a finish at the end. Evans having to make a big change from being a football player to a basketball player. That could be a difficult adjustment.
I'm glad you mentioned that, handling the ball as a big guy, because he was a 5'10 guard freshman in high school. Now he's 6'8". I mean, that's a growth spurt right there. 6'8".
That's a big growth spurt.
Right. Misfires top of the key. As a matter of fact, Norm Roberts says Evans sometimes thinks he can handle the ball like a 5'10 guard, but that's not the case.
Well, that last play against Alexander, Evans was physical, good spacing, good footwork on defense, and he contested the shot.
Now you talked again about pride. You really have to be impressed the way St. John's, maybe not shooting recently, but they're playing hard on the defensive end. Alexander with the dish inside to Deshaun Butler.
St. John's is definitely playing hard, especially Evans. That was hard defense, moving his feet. He slipped a little bit, but he got in there to contest the pass and contest the shot.
A few minutes ago, we saw a graphic where St. John's opened up 3 for 3. They've been struggling with their shot since then. But golf fans and golf pros, it's not too early to start thinking about the 2008 ESPN National Golf Challenge. Log on to ESPNGolf.com to sign your course up as a host or to find a local qualifying site in your area. Be a part of the search for America's best twosome. Yeah. I think I go back to the fact that St. John's has been struggling now. 2 for 9 after opening up 3 for 3. Now, if you're a coach, if you're a leader of the team, how do you avoid that?
Well, you have to regain your composure. Somebody on the court has to take leadership, and that needs to be Anthony Mason Jr. right now and say, hey, let's regain our composure by taking our time, and let's get a shot going to the basket, get fouled.
There's Mason Jr. with the basketball. What a big second half against Seton Hall in that victory. DJ Kennedy, baseline jumper, too strong. Alexander goes up for the rebound, and instead of getting tied up, he's fouled. Larry Wright, the 6'2 sophomore out of Saginaw, Michigan, tried to tie him up. And you talk about this West Virginia team averaging about 36 rebounds, 31 last year, Dickie. And not to embarrass you, but you averaged over 6 rebounds a game in your career. And that career incidentally expanded 125 games, number one all time at Providence. What's the key? What's the key besides being big and strong to being a good rebounder?
The keys to being a good rebounder is one, positioning, defensive positioning and boxing out. The second thing is just having the attitude to go get the ball. I played with a guy named Michael Smith in Providence. He was one of the best rebounders in college basketball at that time. And it wasn't easy grabbing more than 6 rebounds because he was grabbing everything.
Well, don't miss more great Big East Hoops action from ESPN Plus tomorrow. As Jerry Wainwright and his Blue Demons of DePaul, led by Draylon Burns, ahead for Pittsburgh to square off against the likes of Sam Young and those Pitt Panthers. It's DePaul Pittsburgh tomorrow at noon Eastern from ESPN Plus. Well, that's a big one for DePaul if your Friars should go down to Villanova tonight.
Well, the Friars are going to handle their business today, but the DePaul-Pittsburgh game is a big game for DePaul. They have a very exciting freshman on that team, Dar Tucker, who is very explosive.
Now, Dickie, Bob Huggins telling us about a half hour before the game, he said the team's really not shooting that well down the stretch, even though they're playing some pretty good basketball. They come in shooting about 45%, but he said we can shoot better. How about those numbers? That's not too bad, huh?
Well, they're shooting pretty good today, 63%. But when you're struggling to shoot as a team, that's when your character, that's when you get to show your character as an attack team, a patient team, getting fouled and going to the free throw line.
Eugene Lawrence hops, giving a jump, tries to feed it to Kennedy. Too much traffic down in the paint. Here comes West Virginia. They've got numbers. Ruoff missed the shot, but he's fouled. He'll be shooting two.
Ruoff has to finish that shot right there. That was a good go up with the finger roll layup, but I know he is a 3-point shooter.
Inside 8 minutes, so we're going to take a timeout here from Madison Square Garden. Joe Alexander coming off the back-to-back 32-point games. He's got 6, playing well. Back inside Madison Square Garden, where St. John's celebrating 100 years of basketball. Lou Carnesecca, a big part of that history at St. John's. But right now, the Red Storm trailing West Virginia 21-12. Dickie Simpkins, how about Joe Alexander?
It's been the Alexander show so far. Joe Alexander still hot from the last two games. He goes into his face-up game, knocks down jumpers. When you let him seal inside the paint, he's going to elevate with his athleticism. And right here, moving without the ball, again, face-up off the glass. But don't forget, Joe can pass the ball, too. He can find guys in the wide open. He can put the ball on the floor. It's Joe Alexander's show right now.
2 assists to go with those 6 points. Talk about sharing the rock. As a matter of fact, watching West Virginia here in the first half, it's been an assist party for these guys as Ruoff knocks down his 8th point already in the first 20 minutes.
It's always good to see Lou Carnesecca watching the games. I mean, that's a legend right there. When you talk about John Wooden, the legend on the West Coast, you're talking about Lou Carnesecca, the legend on the East Coast.
Yeah, he's one of those guys when he walks into a room, you know, you're with the legend or you're with greatness. So Bob Huggins said about joining the Big East this year. Outside shot, that's a 3 ball. That's Larry Wright, the sophomore from Saginaw, his first bucket.
I always get excited when teams come out of timeouts. As a coach's perspective, or as you look at the game as a coach, you want to see what a team runs coming out of timeout and how they execute.
Another steal, Lawrence. Kennedy using that athleticism to get to the rack. DJ Kennedy, he's got 5.
All it takes is one score to get the team going, to get the momentum change.
Alexander stripped. This time the Red Storm with some numbers. They won't get the bucket, though. Not yet. Wisely, DJ Kennedy kicks it back out into the half-court game. There's a reach by Deshaun Butler.
This is the part of the game where Baby Mace, I'm going to call him Baby Mace, okay, because I played against his dad in the NBA. But as you see this fast break, coming down, being very athletic with the finish, the momentum changer. These things get it going for a team, and they can get back in the game and keep it, you know, real close.
All right, let's get back to Baby Mace. What's going on with Baby Mace?
Baby Mace, I'm expecting him to take over the game at some point in time as he's the leader out here. He has a different style of play than his father, but he's been out here on St. John's team and a veteran player, so I'm looking for him to do some good things.
Another bucket and another three by Wright. He's got back-to-back threes. 8-0 run now for St. John's.
When you're looking for that momentum change, you're looking for a spark plug. Wright is the spark plug right now.
Deshaun Butler, great body control, but it doesn't go down, but he'll be shooting two. Well, I thought he was going to have the three-point play that time.
Yeah, that was great body control. Might have been a little offensive foul, but he set a great pick right here on the ball, an on-ball pick, and he rolled with his hands ready to catch one dribble. Good body control. You want to finish that. You know, whenever you can get a chance to pick a small guy on the court, you know, coming from me being a big guy, whenever you can get a chance to set a pick on a small guy who's always trying to steal a ball from you, you always trying to make sure that's a solid screen.
And you search him out, huh? Yeah. You spot him and you go get him.
You put a radar on him, you go out looking for him.
Deshaun Butler only 1-for-4 now from the free throw line here this afternoon. This is Malik Booth. Another freshman for Norm Roberts. He's the speed guy.
Booth is very quick, very solid. He's going to be a good player here at St. John's.
Light it up. Put three more on the board for Anthony Mason Jr. That's his 36th.
Now that's what I'm talking about, seeing Baby Mace take over the game at some point in time and find his offense.
Norm Roberts saying before the season started, really need this guy to step up, Anthony Mason Jr. And he missed five of the first six games, then three more later in the season. Out of bounds, St. John's on an 11-1 run. And West Virginia just commits their sixth turnover now.
Well, I can understand Coach Roberts' point. Moving forward with a young team, he wants to establish one player on his team that can be a go-to guy. Anthony Mason Jr. can be a go-to guy, so build that confidence in him. So when your freshmen become sophomores, they can play with him and have great, great play on the court.
Mason Jr. up and under. Little scoop shot by Anthony Mason Jr. I think he heard you talking about him over here.
Baby Mace, Baby Mace. That's what I came to see.
Red Storm 13-1 run. There's an update from the nation's capital, Georgetown, early by three over Louisville, 10-7. Now keep in mind, Louisville, they would have the tiebreaker. They beat Georgetown earlier this year in Freedom Hall.
It's funny how when you score a couple of baskets, your defensive intensity turns up a little bit more. Anthony Mason Jr. really playing the passing lane right there to try to come up with a steal. West Virginia being patient like they always are. Backdoor cut to the basket for an easy play and a foul.
Another missed free throw for West Virginia. This time it's John Flowers. Six-seven freshman comes in shooting 38% from the line. Knocks this one down, his first point.
Well, that last one didn't look like 38%. Yeah, great extension, great follow through. Whenever you're shooting free throws and your percentage is not good, it can become mental. But as long as you stay with your routine and stay with your follow through with your fingers pointing at the rim, you'll eventually get it going.
Well, I think he'll work it out. He's got great bloodlines. There's another foul. I mean, his mom was a three-time All-American at Louisiana Tech, Pam Kelly Flowers, recently inducted into the Hall of Fame. So Nichols just picked up his second, incidentally.
So he has basketball in his blood, huh, Mike?
Basketball in his blood. And I'm sure mom, a Hall of Famer, 38% doesn't cut it at home from the charity stripe.
No, that sounds like some tough dinners at home when mom's, when mom's sitting at the dinner table correcting you on your free throw shooting.
Partially deflected. Good hustle that time. So Nichols with two fouls, how does that affect this offense because he plays such an integral part?
It can affect the offense a little bit depending on how the guys coming off the bench come in and play. West Virginia has solid players coming in to help give some reserve minutes and play solid. Right there, you can see that great pass.
Yep, Joel Mazzulla, Deshaun Butler missed the chance for the three-point play again. He'll go back to the line.
When you have a guy like Mazzulla that can come in and give solid minutes and be steady and see guys cutting, you don't really miss or you don't really lose a lot when Nichols is in foul trouble.
That's a great point. They love Mazzulla, at least Bob Huggins does. As a matter of fact, he said Mazzulla reminds him of himself, the way he plays. Not afraid to mix it up, go after a loose ball, get a rebound.
Well, your point guard is your general. He's the leader, the general. He usually sets the tone when the game starts. And then your other guy will set the tone as your go-to player.
Who's the tough guy, the point guard that you played with at Providence?
Wow, I know when I came in as a freshman, I played with Eric Murdoch at Providence. That's when it was EMT time. And I really learned a lot because he was a senior and a leader. And he was our go-to guy, and he was the point guard.
But Murdoch averaged 1 year 25.7 points a game.
I watched him score 45 points against Arizona. Those days, Chris Mills, Sean Rooks, Brian Williams.
Seven on the shot clock for Evans, high off the window. And Deshaun Butler pulls down the rebound. Butler outside. It's a three.
I really like Deshaun Butler's game. Coming back after a great freshman year, he's a solid wing player, solid guard, very athletic, can rebound and knock down shots.
Very steady, 14 and 13 against DePaul, 9 and 7 against UConn. Patateo misses his first shot. He's another rookie. And Evans gets the rebound, and he's fouled. When we come back, Sean Evans, the big freshman, will be at the line. But Anthony Mason Jr., following your lead, Dickie Simpkins, he's starting to warm up. Anthony Mason Jr. averaging 14. He's got 7 here. Well, back inside Madison Square Garden, 3 minutes and 12 seconds to go, along with Dickie Simpkins, Mike Leeson here. Great to have you with us for this Big East battle, 29 to 25. You look at St. John's, Dickie, they had some fight this year. I mean, they were blown out by Georgetown. They came back. They were down by 16 against South Florida. They won that game. They lost the number one score, came back, picked up another victory. And here they are battling West Virginia. And as you mentioned at the top of the broadcast, Mountaineers with a lot at stake in this game as well.
Well, St. John's can be a spoiler today. And we're playing in the Mecca, Madison Square Garden. A lot of strange things happen here in this arena. And St. John's can spoil West Virginia's NCAA bid.
What's your greatest memory here playing? How about the first time you played on this court? What was it like?
The first time I ever played on this court, I just walked in and looked around this arena, and I said, it's been a lot of great players here. My best memory here, Big East tournament championship game, that whole tournament in 1994 when we won the whole Big East tournament at Providence, that's probably my biggest memory here, aside from MJ scoring about 55 in this gym.
As Alexander is showing some of his athleticism, boy, there's been some great games, though, huh? MJ scoring some of those great.
Yeah, somebody done guard Alexander, he might score 55.
Mason Jr., he's got that look in his eye. Malik Booth. Paris Horn, that's a three.
You know, I get excited when I watch college basketballs get passes and they square up and they follow through on every shot. Young kids today need to understand that you need to follow through on every shot you take.
Malik Booth, the young freshman, picked up his second foul. And let's go back and take a look at Joe Alexander now.
The Alexander show, showing his athletic ability, getting it down, one strong bounce, going and exploding with the one-hand dunk. He can definitely do that.
40-inch vertical. They have this drill where they have one bounce from maybe 5 yards away from the basket. They said earlier this year he went up and he was about at least 2.5 feet above the rim.
Wow, 40-inch vertical.
That's pretty impressive.
He's got a good size for his position. Again, he's a face-up player. He can shoot the ball, and the best thing about him is he can take bigger players off the dribble.
I mentioned that drill. You have a 5-yard start, but you know he's really strong, Dickie, is just going straight up. Without a head start. He's got some great lift. You can even see on his jump shot. Paris Horn. That's rejected. West Virginia comes in averaging about five blocks, but they have about three deflections and a couple of blocks here already today. Ruoff, nice job of chasing down the offensive rebound, but couldn't find the handle.
Well, the best time to block a shot is when somebody's guarding a man one-on-one, and like Smith did, you come from the other side, you time it, and you get that good block.
That weak side defense, huh?
Weak side defense is very important.
I've heard Hasheem Thabeet and Roy Hibbert both talk about it. It's fun coming from the weak side when they don't expect it.
Yeah, that's the best thing about it. Nobody expects it, and then you get to blast the shot into the fourth row. Even though you want to keep it in play, you get an opportunity to really bat it out of there, give a Barry Bonds back.
Too strong by Malik. Booth, Lawrence, the senior. Thought about it, gives it up. Horn, the freshman. Another one too strong. So Mason, no touches in that possession. Smith outside, that's a three ball. Wellington Smith, the 6'7 sophomore from Summit, New Jersey.
St. John's definitely needs to find Anthony Mason Jr. When you're playing and you're getting ready and you're building for the future, you want to find your go-to guy. He was hot for a second. You want to come out and keep him hot.
Final 45 seconds here in the first 20 minutes. Madison Square Garden. Regular season finale for both St. John's and West Virginia.
It's important that we get a score here.
Another rejection.
Smith with the Barry Bonds.
There's a timeout called by Bob Huggins with 25.4 left. Well, West Virginia turning into a shot blocking machine here on the final day of the regular season.
Well, Smith, I think that Smith or is that Barry Bonds batting these basketballs out of the arena right now. No. He's coming on the other side. He's timing it just right.
Well, Wellington Smith came in tied for the lead with 45 blocks with Joe Alexander. And let's check some NCAA news and notes now. Of course, coming up at 9 o'clock tonight on ESPN, number one against number five. Boy, they've had some classic battles over the years, haven't they? ACC championship on the line for the regular season. And, of course, some teams punching their tickets as early as today for the NCAA. And the UCLA goes for a Pac-10 clincher. The Bruins are hosting Cal this afternoon at Pauley Pavilion. Let's get back and talk about number one against number five, Duke and Carolina.
That's definitely a rivalry that goes down in history. North Carolina, Duke, whenever they play, it's a big game. The kids, they sleep outside the arena and get the tickets. Unfortunately, with the death of the school president at North Carolina, it brings some somber to the game. But I like how Coach K said, you know, we're playing to kind of dedicate her.
Yeah, the student body president, Eve Carson. What a tragic story that is. What an impressive young lady she was, too. The valedictorian of her class in high school. And she was a pre-med student teaching a science class in Chapel Hill to an elementary school. Found shot to death earlier this week in Chapel Hill.
It really puts things in perspective and shows you that basketball is not that important. You know, that is definitely a tragedy and a heartfelt situation with the student body and with everybody in North Carolina and where she's from in Georgia.
And just last year in the NCAA tournament, Jason Ray, the mascot, hit by a car and killed in East Rutherford, New Jersey, as Missoula knocks down both from the line. 37-28 now, West Virginia. Final 12 seconds here in the first half. Who gets the shot, Dickey?
Got to go to Anthony Mason Jr. Got to give it to Baby Mace.
Lawrence gets it with the left hand. He scores.
Well, I can take that also. If I'm a senior, it's my last game. That'll be my second option, taking a shot myself.
All right, let's go back and update the star watch, Dickey.
Alexander has definitely done well in the first half. He hasn't disappointed us. Anthony Mason got hot for a second. They need to find him and continue to stay with him.
And maybe Anthony Mason.